गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, साईराम, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन, राइट? सो इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट वी सॉ व्हाट आर कोस्टल प्लेन्स, ओके, एंड द टू डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कोस्टल प्लेन्स. सो व्हाट आर देयर? दे आर ईस्टर्न कोस्टल प्लेन एंड द वेस्टर्न कोस्टल प्लेन, राइट? सो व्हाट वॉज देयर इन द वेस्टर्न कोस्टल प्लेन? So in the western coastal plain, we saw that it started from Gujarat and it ends in Kanyakumari. That is the southernmost tip of the peninsula, right? The western coastal plain was divided into three parts. So what are those three parts? It is Gujarat or the Saurashtra coast, the Konkan coast in the middle, and the Malabar coast, which is below the Konkan coast, right? And this western coastal plain ends in the southernmost tip of India, which is the Kanyakumari, okay? So the western coastal plain is divided into three parts. They are the Saurashtra coast, Konkan coast, and the Malabar coast. So next we have the eastern coastal plains. So the eastern coastal plain is divided into two parts. So the first part, which is starting from the West Bengal, okay, it is called as a northern circass. So it is called as a northern circass, right? So second one is a Coromandel coast, which lies below the northern circass. Okay, so first one is northern circass, it starts from West Bengal, and the second one is the Coromandel coast, right? The western coast is divided into three parts and the eastern coastal plain is divided into two parts. Now we are going to see what are islands. Okay, so there are few islands that are present near the Arabian Sea, near the Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal. So let's see what are those islands and what are special about those islands. Okay, so in today's session we are going to see about the islands that are present in Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal. So shall we move on to today's class? Yes, are you ready with your pencils and your notebooks? Fine. So let's move on to today's class. So before knowing what are islands that are present in the Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal, how many of you know what are islands? Okay, so let me say what is an island. An island or an isle is any piece of subcontinental land that is surrounded by water. Repeat. An island or an isle is any piece of subcontinental land that is surrounded by water. So a peninsula is a piece of land which is surrounded by three sides of water, okay? But an island is an isle or a subcontinent land which is surrounded by four parts of water, okay? So can you see the picture of an island here? So it is a piece of land that is situated surrounded by four sides of water. So that is an island, okay? So now let us see what are the islands that are present in the Bay of Bengal, okay? So the Andaman and the Nicobar Islands are a group of islands situated in the Bay of Bengal. Repeat. The Andaman and the Nicobar Islands are the group of islands that are present in the Bay of Bengal. So the Andaman and the Nicobar Islands are a group of islands situated in the Bay of Bengal. So next, let us see how are these islands named. Okay, so can you see this red lighted dots? So this part only is called as the Andaman and the Nicobar Island. I'll just show you an enlarged view about this. So see, these are the group of islands that are situated in Bay of Bengal. Okay, so they are differentiated as Andaman, Great Andaman, Little Andaman, North Andaman, Middle Andaman, South Andaman, Port Blair, South Nicobar and Nicobar. So repeat, Andaman, North Andaman, Middle Andaman, South Andaman, and these all together are called as Great Andaman, and a small pinch of land that is present below, it is called as the Little Andaman. Okay, so let's see about Andaman and Nicobar Island. Okay, these are two groups of about 300 islands in the Bay of Bengal. So learn this, it's very important. See here, these are two groups of about 300 islands in the Bay of Bengal. The northern islands are known as the Andaman Islands, and the southern islands are known as the Andaman Islands, and the southern islands are known as the Nicobar Islands. The southernmost part of the islands are called as Indra Point. So there are important fill in the blanks and one mark answers here. So note it down. There are two groups of about 300 islands in Bay of Bengal. The northern islands are known as the Andaman Islands, and the southern islands are known as the Nicobar Islands. The southernmost part of the islands are called as Indra Point. The southernmost islands are called as the Indra Point. Okay, so this Andaman and Nicobar Island is one of the union territories of India. So the Andaman and Nicobar Island are one of the union territories of India. Okay, and Port Blair is the capital of Andaman. Port Blair is the capital of Andaman. So the crops that grow in Andaman are rice and coconut. So the crops that grow in Andaman are rice and coconut. So next let us see about the we come across the Lakshadweep Islands. So the Lakshadweep Islands are situated in the Arabian Sea. So can you see this? This is the Lakshadweep Islands, and it is one of the smallest union territory of India. So Lakshadweep is one of the smallest union territory of India. So Lakshadweep, there are a group of, repeat, there are a group of 30 islands. So in Andaman it is 300 islands, and in Lakshadweep it is 30 islands. Only some of which are inhabited. So among these 30 islands, only a few are accompanied by people who are living there. And in some islands there are nobody. Okay. They are close to the Malabar coast. They also form a union territory. Many of these islands are made up of corals. And such islands are called as coral islands. Okay? So Lakshadweep Islands, they are a group of 300 islands, only some of which are inhabited. They are close to the Malabar coast, and they also form a union territory. Many of these islands are made up of corals, and such islands are called as coral islands. So the major crops grown in Lakshadweep are bananas, edible roots and millets. So what are the crops grown in Lakshadweep? It's the bananas, edible roots and millets. So now let us move on to the life in the western coastal plains. So now let's move on to the life in the western coastal plains. So as I told you, in the western coastal plains, what are the main cities present? So the main cities present in the western coastal plains are, so the main states and cities, so the main states that are present in the western coastal plain are, it's the Gujarat, so Gujarat, Maharashtra, Karnataka and Kerala. So it is Gujarat, Maharashtra, Karnataka and Kerala. So let's see how is the life of the people who live in the western coastal plains according to the states. Okay, so first let's see about Gujarat. So Gujarat lies in the northwest of India. Its capital is Gandhinagar. So Gujarat lies in the northwest of India and its capital is Gandhinagar. So its capital is Gandhinagar. Trading and farming. Trading and farming are the main occupations of people of the state. Trading and farming are the main occupations of the people of the state. Gujarat has several well-developed industries. Gujarat has several well-developed industries. It is known for its textile, petroleum, fertilizer, salt and diamond cutting industries. So Gujarat lies in the northwest of India. Its capital is Gandhinagar. Trading and farming are the main occupations of the people of the state and Gujarat has several well-developed industries. It is known for its textile, petroleum, fertilizer, salt and diamond cutting industries. The main language spoken here is Gujarati. The main language that is spoken here is Gujarati. The women wear saris and lehengas. The women wear saris and lehengas. The men traditionally wear chudidars and short jackets called angrahas. The women wear saris and lehengas. The men traditionally wear chudidars and short jackets called angrahas with colorful turbans. So with colorful turbans. Ahmedabad is the largest city in Gujarat. Gandhiji's Sabarmati Ashram lies in this city. Gandhiji's Sabarmati Ashram lies in this city. So what is main about Gujarat? Gujarat lies in the northwest of India. Its capital is Gandhinagar and trading and farming are the main occupations here. So Gujarat has several well-developed industries like textiles, petroleum, fertilizer, salt and diamond cutting industries. And next, the main language spoken here is Gujarati and women wear saris and lehengas and men wear angrahas with colorful turban. So the largest city of Gujarat is Ahmedabad and Gandhiji's Sabarmati Ashram lies in this city. Okay, so the Gir Forest, which is the home of Asiatic lion, is an important tourist attraction here. So they'll ask you questions like this also: where is Gir Forest situated? So they will give you choose or fill in the blanks. So now you have come to fourth standard. It is very essential that you should read the complete lesson from your textbooks and not only revise the questions that are given at the back of your textbooks. You should read each and every word that is present in your textbooks, and questions can come in whatever way the teacher prefers. Okay, so next is Maharashtra. The Konkan coast runs through Maharashtra. Mumbai is the capital of Maharashtra. So important 1 mark question: lies on the Konkan coast. It is the biggest seaport in India. The seabed of the Konkan coast has large deposits of petroleum. This region is called as Bombay High. Okay, the seabed of the Konkan coast has large deposits of petroleum, and this region is called as Bombay High. So remember children, you learned this in your third standard also, right? So this Bombay High you have learned in the lesson Maharashtra. Yes, some special cities, remember? So it's a very very important question. Okay, next one is Goa. To the south of Maharashtra is the small and beautiful state of Goa. Its capital is Panaji. Goa is rich in iron ore. Mining is an important industry in this state. And here there are many Christians who live here, and many foreigners and tourists come here. So Christmas is the main festival celebrated in this state. So what is the main festival celebrated in Goa? It is Christmas. Tourists visit Goa in large numbers every year because of its beautiful beaches and churches. The Basilica of Bom Jesus in Panaji is one of the oldest churches in India. So this can also be asked as a 1 mark question. It contains the body of Saint Francis Xavier. Right? So next we go on to Karnataka. As we go south from Goa, that is below Goa we have Karnataka. So along the coast we come to Karnataka. Mangalore is an important seaport that is present in Karnataka, and we have read about this in last chapter. So next we have Kerala. So how many of you have been to Kerala? Yes, it is a very very important tourist place, and it's God's own country, you can see. So in the extreme south of the western coastal plain lies the beautiful state of Kerala. Thiruvananthapuram, earlier known as Trivandrum, is the capital of Kerala. So Trivandrum is the capital of Kerala, and Kochi is an important seaport of Kerala. Kerala produces large quantities of spices, coconut, cashew, coffee and rubber. Kerala produces large quantities of spices, that is coconut, cashew, coffee and rubber. Okay, so next we have almost the entire population of Kerala knows to read and write. So they are all educated people there. And all the people know to read and write. So the main language here is Malayalam. The men wear lungi called mundu and short. The women wear mundu and blouses or saris. So the women wear mundu and blouse or saris. Okay. Onam and Vishu are the important festivals of Kerala. So all of you who have Malayali friends would be knowing that the two important festivals which they celebrate are Onam and Vishu. Kathakali is a traditional form of dance in Kerala. Kerala has a number of beautiful beaches, the most famous being the Kovalam beach. The lagoons or backwaters of Kerala, the wildlife sanctuary at Periyar, and the famous temples are the tourist attractions of Kerala. So the lagoons or backwaters of Kerala, the wildlife sanctuary at Periyar, and the famous temples are other tourist attractions here. Okay, so children, I want you to write down in separate tabular columns, writing like Gujarat, Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka and Kerala, and you are going to list out the important points that are taught you in this lesson. Okay, so it's just a small homework for you so that you will be able to differentiate between these states and learn the important points. It will be a different way of learning. Okay, so learn all the lessons thoroughly. You have come to a big standard. From third you are promoted to fourth, so you have to learn to read the lesson from the first page till the last page and answer any question that is asked inside the textbook. Okay, thank you children, stay safe at home. Okay.